Hello and welcome to the next video of our WeChat++ series. In this video, we will talk about how you can I will show you how you can inspect your schedule file by using the WeChat++ analyzer. Using this button, you can start the analyzer. So first of all, you need to load one SKD file, which is schedule. So I can load any of the SKD files that I have generated. Now the session is loaded and you can start the analyzer. After starting the analyzer, a new graphical user interface appears. And here, on the main page, you can see the sky coverage of all the stations, or maximum of 8 of the participating stations. I will change the layout real quick for you to better see what's going on. Okay, now we are looking at the sky coverage from station Hadrao and from station Cookie. What you can see here is all these different dots, and every dot corresponds to one observation. You can see that there are different colors. You can add the legend to see that what they mean. So this is basically information about the cable wrap the observation was done at. So for example, red would be the counterclockwise cable wrap, green would be the standard cable wrap or the neutral cable wrap, and blue would be the clockwise cable wrap. Next, you can see this gray area here, and that's basically the horizon mask of the station. So for example, you can see that station Cookie has quite some area where it's not allowed to observe. I will remove the legend again. And what you can see here on the right is a list of all these sources that you are observing. And we can now filter this list, for example, and you can also highlight some observations. For example, if you're mostly interested in some sources, you can highlight and they are now displayed in yellow. By hovering an element, you will see when the observation occurred and what's the azimuth elevation and so on. What you can also see is at the bottom here, there is this two little sliders that let you filter the time series from or the let you filter the session based on the time. So by default, you're looking at the full session duration from the start time till the end time. But you can use the sliders to adjust the time that you want to look at. And for example, you can look only at 1 hour at a time. And if you're not now taking the start and stop slider, you can move them a little bit to really have a look at how the sky coverage looks like over 1 hour at a time. Then there are some other options. For example, here there's a world map, and this basically tells you when the observations are. For example, if I go back and I only look at, let's say, 1 second at a time, so then you can browse through and you really see for every second which network is observing together. So for example, here would be a case where some stations are observing one source, some stations are observing another source, and so on. So this is, again, some subnetting that's going on. Okay, next slide here, you would see the UV coverage of the different sources. And again, you can use the sliders to change the observations. Finally, here would be the sky map, where you see which sources are observed in which time frame. So far, so good. Here are some more statistics that you can see. So for example, here you see the number of scans and observations and also how many scans and observations are in this given time frame here. So if I go to the full time span again, you can see that we have in total 15,000 observations in this session. Here you also see the distribution on of how many stations are usually observing per scan. So it can be 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And you also get a histogram of the observing duration that we have, as well as some statistics down here. And again, you can have a look at how this distribution changes over time. Here, you see a lot more statistics for these stations. For example, how many scans and observations they have, and so on. And also how they spend their time. For example, do they have a lot of idle time, observing time, and so on. So it's quite an interactive tool, and it's basically quite nice to explore how your scheduling went. So for example, you should be able to see that at some point at the very start, we get a lot of idle time for Cookie and Wetzel, because during this time, this station Cookie and Wetzel were not observing because they were participating in an intensive scan or in an intensive session. Here you have some information about the or every source, so basically showing you the azimuth elevation of all the sources. And finally, you have some plots showing you how often each baseline is observed. So for example, if you would like to know, for example, what station at Rao or which station at Rao is usually observing, then you can do so in this plot by simply filtering for station at Rao, and then you have here the overview, and the darker the color is, the more observations you will have. So for example, here we would not see any observation between Cookie and Hat Rao, and only very few observations between Hat Rao and Seichang, but a lot of observations between the other stations. You can also filter them here, of course. Okay, this was basically everything I would like to, wanted to show you about the VSHAD++ analyzer. In principle, it's a nice and handy tool to have a look at your schedule and get a more visual overview of what's going on and how your performance was. Of course, there's a lot more to discover here, but now the task is really up to you to just try it out and use it and try to understand what's going on here. Okay, then see you at the next video.